ها قد تنام حلمكم من مثلكم قد حاز من دنياه حفظا للكتاب.
There was something very special about Abu Hanifa. We said he was very generous. Was very generous. He had a habit, a very special habit. And I really wish that I would hear of someone in our times who actually does what Abu Hanifa did. Abu Hanifa, every time he spent any money on his family or on himself, he would give out for the sake of Allah similar amount. Like he bought his family groceries and it cost him $200, let's say. He would take another $200 and give it for the sake of Allah. Let's say he bought his son a thawb. It cost $20. He would give out $20. Anything he spent on himself or his family, he would give a similar amount for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He would give it out. That actually reminds me of Ali ibn al-Husayn ibn Ali radiyallahu anhum ajma'in, the Zayd al-Abidin, the grandson of Ali ibn Abi Talib, the son of al-Husayn. Like when Imam al-Dhahabi talks about him in Sirah Alam al-Nubala, in the biography, collection of biographies, he says, جَعَلَ مَالَهُ مُنَاصَفَةً بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ جَعَلَ مَالَهُ مُنَاصَفَةً بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ. What does that mean? He split his money between himself and Allah. What does that mean? A few times in his life, he would estimate his wealth, how much it is. So, and he was very rich, by the way, again. Ali, the grandson of Ali ibn Abi Talib, Ali ibn Husayn, Zain al-Abidin, was very rich. So a few times during his life, he would assess how much is my wealth. So if it was 100,000, he would take half of it and give it for the sake of Allah and keep half of it. There were actually a few people in the history of Islam who lived that lifestyle. So they would take a few times in their life, they would assess their wealth, they would take half of it, and they would give it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Imam Abu Hanifa would do something similar. Anything he spent on himself or his family, he would give out similar amount for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.